B-Monster Laboratory here. Today we're going to talk about a sound sensor module. This is also lesson 20 in the Elegoo Mega 2560 tutorial. This module has four pins. We're going to talk about the pins, we're going to talk about the microphone, we're going to talk about the code, and the serial plotter. Let's begin right now. Today I'll be using the Elegoo Mega 2560. So you'll need your board, you'll need the sound sensor module, and then four male to female jumper wires. As you can see, this module has four pins, an AO pin, a G pin, a plus pin, and a DO pin. The G pin is the ground pin, and then your plus pin is obviously the voltage pin. But you look up here at the AO pin, that is your analog output. That is a real-time output voltage signal from the microphone. If you look down here at the DO pin, that is the digital output pin. And when the intensity of the sound reaches a certain threshold, the output from this pin is either a high signal or a low signal. And threshold sensitivity can be changed by using this screw right here on the top of the potentiometer. This potentiometer is very precise, so it'll probably take a couple of turns of the screw before you really see any results. This module is really good at picking up sound, and it's often used to detect sound intensity, which really gives it a broad range of usefulness over many applications. It's an excellent module for use in security applications. You can use it as a switch to switch on a camera or recording device or lights. I also see applications for hearing impaired. It could help hearing impaired, and we'll explore some of those in my next video. But for now, just know that you're limited only by your own creativity, what you can do with this thing. I love this module. And its accuracy is easily adjusted by this screw right here on top of the potentiometer, which really makes this just a really versatile module, I think. Now, it uses a microphone, and that supplies input to an amplifier, a peak detector, and a buffer. So if the sensor picks up a sound, it'll send out an output signal voltage, which is then sent to your microcontroller. And then from there, it'll perform whatever function that you have it set up to do. So these microphones are used in a whole bunch of different circuits. And typically, they're used to detect small, minor sounds or air vibrations. And they take that and convert that into an electrical signal. As you can see, the microphone has a solid metal body. And it kind of holds various parts of the microphone. And the top is covered with a porous material, kind of like felt material. And this is porous, and it's just held on with glue. And it acts like a filter for dust particles. It doesn't allow other things in. And the sound signals and vibrations will pass through this felt material, through a hole, and onto the diaphragm, which is within this metal enclosure. So I'll start by connecting my first wire here. The first wire here is AO, so I want to go ahead and connect that to my analog output zero, A0. My next pin is ground. I'm going to use my green cable, my green wire for ground, and I'm going to connect that to the ground pin. My next pin is positive, so I'll use my blue jumper here to connect that to the 5-volt pin on my microcontroller. And then my bottom pin here is my DO pin, my digital output. I'm going to connect that to my digital output pin number 3. Now we're going to take a look at the code here. You want to go to the Elegoo Mega 2560 tutorial and select sound sensor example. It's in lesson 20 for the sound sensor. Slip on down here and you see some variables that are defined. These are variables that we use and the setup and the loop of our code. And basically this says that the sound sensor analog pin is A0. A0 is the pin that we used for our analog output on our sensor. Here it says sensor digital pin is 3, and that is correct. We did use the digital output on our sensor into pin 3 on our Elegoo board. And down here it says analog value is 0, and it gives you a definition of the digital value right over here. Here it says LED 13 equals 13. This is the LED that is built into the Arduino labeled L. Here's the built-in LED here on your board. It is labeled L. So when the digital output from your sound sensor sends a high signal, L will light up, as you can see it lighting up right now. Now you should see LED 13 on your board labeled L right here light up only when the LED 2 is maxed out at 100%. So this tells me that I need to turn it down a little bit. So I just use a fine flathead screwdriver to turn it down just a little bit. I'm going to turn it counterclockwise until, so if I talk in a regular tone, you can see that it's picking up my voice here on the LED 2, but not on L0. And I have to raise my voice for L to come on the board because it's maxing out at 100%. Next thing we'll do is go down here to setup. Now we're going to look at the plotter next, and the plotter requires 9600 baud speed. So you want to make sure that's in your setup. If you're going to look at the plotter's right up here. We'll turn on in just a second. So if we look down here, we have pin mode. Pin mode tells us how a pin is going to behave, whether it's an input or an output. It tells us a sensor digital pin is an input. It also tells us LED 13 is an output. We come down to this line right here, and this is basically submitting the value that you get up here at your analog read into the serial transmit interface. So then we come down to the next line here. If the digital value is high, you'll see your LED 13 light up. If not, your LED 13 light will be low. So that's basically what that's saying. Down here, you have the delay of 50 milliseconds, so you're just not bombarding your board with all this data. So that is your code, fairly simple. Let's take a look at the plotter. So now we can take a look at our serial plotter. If you click on Tools and go down to Serial Plotter, you can see that when you speak into the microphone or when it picks up your sound, you can observe waveforms that change. And if I stop speaking, it'll flatline. And I can adjust this waveform by adjusting the screw on the potentiometer on my sound sensor. So here's my sound sensor, and when I speak, you can see this LED light up as it should. And every time it lights up, it sends a waveform onto the serial plotter. That's it, pretty simple. This is how you connect your sound sensor module to your Elegoo microcontroller. And this is real-time waveforms in the serial plotter as I speak. We've went ahead and taken a look at the sound sensor module. So that's all there is to connecting your sound sensor module to your board and understanding at least a little bit about the connections. That's all I've got for today. As always, thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. And I'll see you again very soon.